The question is ladder envelope. A ladder initially stands vertically against a wall. Its bottom end is given a sideways kick, causing the ladder to slide down. Assuming that the bottom end is constrained to keep contact with the ground and the top end is constrained to keep contact with the wall, describe the envelope of ladder's position.
Hi guys, welcome to the channel Basic Learning. I am Vineeth. Today we are going to discuss the solution for the question number 2, that is the ladder envelope. Okay, before going to discuss the solution with this question, if you want more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to get notifications about our new videos. In this series Brainstormers, we will upload the difficult questions of maths, physics with their easiest solutions. These questions are collected from various sources, including the most popular reference book to the most popular websites, and also from the world's most famous universities and their professors. For this particular question, there are two solutions. One is a pure mathematical approach, and another one is having a physics tinge. A small concept of physics can be used to solve this problem easily. Both processes are almost similar in length, but this mathematical approach can be understood by all the students. Whereas if we coming to the second physics way, that cannot be understood by all. You need to know a small concept before seeing that process. Okay, let us leave that aside. Now I am going to concentrate on the first process. After that I will discuss the second problem. Second process. The first process is the mathematical approach. Here the ladder envelope is nothing but we know that as the ladder moves, it covers some particular points in space. The envelope denotes that those all the points enclose an area with the coordinate axis. The border of that area is nothing but the envelope. Okay, to find that envelope, it is nothing but, let us suppose in initial position ladder is at AB, and after moving a small little bit it came to CD. Let us say this angle is theta, therefore this is a small greater than theta. The finding envelope is nothing but the finding locus of point P. In order to do so, I will assume this as x-axis and this as y-axis. And let us say this is h, k. This is the general locus point. In order to do so, okay, look carefully what I am doing. I am drawing a line parallel to AC and through B. It is intersecting CD at point E. Now if we see carefully, triangle ACP is similar to triangle BEP. ACP is similar to BEP. Therefore, triangle I am going to get the ratio, that is the ratio in which their sizes are kept. No, our agenda is nothing but we want to find out the ratio of the sizes of these two triangles. This ratio can be found out by using the ratio of AC and BE, that is equal to AC by BE. In order to find AC, let us name this as O. AC is equal to AO minus CO. For simplicity, I am assuming the length of the ladder as 1. AO is nothing but 1 sin theta plus d theta, that is sin theta plus d theta. And next, CO. CO is nothing but CD sin theta. CD is nothing but 1. I assume the length of the ladder as 1 minus sin theta. We know formula of sin C minus sin D, that is equal to 2 cos C plus D by 2 sin C minus D by 2. That is equal to cos theta d theta. And coming to the length of BE, I am finding length of BD, and I will find BE by taking tan theta is equal to BE by BD. BE is equal to BD tan theta. So I will find BD. BD is equal to DO minus BO. DO is nothing but CD cos theta. That is equal to cos theta. Minus BO is nothing but cos theta plus D theta. That is equal to 2 sin C plus D by 2 sin D minus C by 2. This is BD. This is AC. And BE is equal to BD tan theta. That is equal to sin square theta by cos theta D theta. Now I want to substitute the value of BE and AC in this to get the ratio of sizes of the triangles ACP and BEP. I will substitute BE and AC in this. So I will get R is equal to AC, that is cos theta D theta, by sin square theta by cos theta D theta, that is cos square theta by sin square theta D theta. D theta, D theta will get cancelled anyway. Therefore, that is equal to cot square theta. Now, in order to find locus of P, I will find H. H is nothing but this distance. This is H. And this distance is K. Okay, in order to find H, H is nothing but H is equal to, I will use OB in this. If I divide, this point P divides this length OB. These two parts will be divided in the ratio R is to 1. Therefore, H is equal to OB into R by R plus 1. And K is equal to, similarly, OA is divided in that format. K is equal to OA into 1 by R plus 1. Here, this value is OB into R is nothing but cot square theta. Cot square theta by 1 plus cot square theta. That is cot square theta by cosecant square theta. That is cos square theta. That is equal to OA into, this is 1 by cot square theta plus 1. This is 1 by cosecant square theta. That is sin square theta. Here you need not use the relation OA square plus OB square is equal to 1. We can simply find out OB. OB is nothing but AB cos theta plus D theta. As d theta is small, we can neglect that term. Therefore, OB is equal to cos theta. Therefore, this is equal to cos cube theta. And OA is equal to AB sin theta plus d theta. As d theta is very small, sin theta plus d theta is equal to sin theta. Therefore, this is equal to sin cube theta. Therefore, we can easily find the locus of H, K as we got them in the terms of trigonometric formats. Therefore, H power 2 by 3 plus k power 2 by 3 is equal to 1. As you know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, this is our required locus. It is nothing but the ladder envelope. It is the envelope of the ladder. Okay, now I am going to discuss the highlights of this particular process. Coming to the first highlight point. The first highlight point in this particular process is the concept of similar triangles that is used in the first step. That is the point E. This is the first point of highlight. We want to get this idea because we need to get this distance. And we know the distance of OB. In order to do so, we need to split this into two parts. In order to get the ratio of these two parts, we need to use something. Here that something is nothing but the concept of similar triangles. From that we will get the ratio. Therefore, this is the first highlight point in this video. And the second highlight point is the way of finding BD and AC. In order to get BD and AC, here you need not apply the direct approximation that as D theta is negligible, therefore theta plus D theta is very small, therefore sin theta cancel at 0. In such cases, do not directly go for approximation. Instead, you can use the sin theta 1 minus sin theta 2 formula. And our next point of concern is this OB. This is the second point of concern. While finding OB, we should note one thing that here theta plus d theta, d theta is negligible. That approximation can be used here. but not here, because as both the quantities are approximately same, if we neglect d theta here, we will get an answer as 0, but here we can neglect the d theta, because the answer will not change that much by neglecting d theta, but here it is changing, as the minus sign is there and approximately equal quantity is present here. Here it is the second point of concern. You should neglect the d theta and use this right angle triangle to get value of OB. These two are the highlight points in this particular process. Okay, now I want to discuss the second solution. This solution is based on physics approach. Okay, now before going to this solution, I want you to learn this particular concept of instantaneous axis of rotation. I want to use that particular concept in solving this question. If you don't know that, please refer to that concept and then come again to see this particular solution. Okay, in order to find the instantaneous axis of rotation, the technique we use is particularly in a rigid body. Suppose I have a rigid body like this of some shape, and it is having one velocity like this, velocity of point A, and this is velocity of point B. This is point B and this is velocity of point B. Instantaneous axis of rotation is nothing but if we stand on that particular axis and see that rigid body, we will see that every point is only rotating about that particular axis. That is, there is no translational motion. That is, if we stand on instantaneous axis of rotation, we will observe that all the points are rotating in concentric circles which center on that instantaneous axis of rotation. In order to find instantaneous axis of rotation, we will take the perpendiculars from two velocities of any two points. See, this is perpendicular, this is perpendicular, and the point of intersection of these two perpendiculars is nothing but our instantaneous axis of rotation, that is IA over R. Using this concept, now we are going to solve that particular question of ladder envelope. If we see a ladder, I am considering a ladder like this. This point will move like this. This point will move like this. Okay? I am drawing perpendiculars like this. Those two are meeting at this point. Therefore, this is instantaneous axis of rotation. Now, the logic here about finding envelope is we need to consider those points whose velocity is parallel to the rod. Remember this, parallel to the rod. Why I am stressing the word parallel? Because envelope, as I already mentioned, envelope is nothing but if there are infinite possibilities for a particular, for a ladder. That is, it is sliding like this. That is, it will cover different points in a particular plane. If we draw an outline of those all the points covered by those by that ladder, the outline gives the envelope. In order to find the outline, suppose if it is not having the velocity parallel to the rod, suppose it is having some component of velocity perpendicular to the rod, it means what? The point is moving inside that ladder. Therefore, it will move inside. That is, it is not the outline. We require what? Outline. Therefore, we need the velocity parallel to the rod. Therefore, I should drop a perpendicular from instantaneous axis of rotation to the rod. This is our required point P. And let us say this angle is theta. In order to find, this is origin, this is A and this is B. I will assume IA over as I. Let us say this is as capital I. Okay. Now I need to find out this locus. That is, let us assume P as H comma K. This distance is H, this distance is K as previously assumed. I will take the help of OB, as OB is equal to IA. OB is nothing but OA tan theta. This is OA tan theta. If this is theta, this is 90 minus theta. Therefore, if this is OA tan theta, this is OA tan theta sin theta. If this is OA tan theta sin theta, this particular length is OA tan theta sin theta cos theta. That is OA sin square theta. Therefore, this distance, now I will name it as OH, this is OK. OH is equal to OA minus OA tan theta, sin theta, cos theta. This is nothing but sin square theta. Therefore, OA into 1 minus sin square theta, that is equal to OA cos square theta. As previously discussed, this OA is nothing but AB cos theta. AB cos theta. Therefore, this is AB cos cube theta. Similarly, OK is equal to AB sin cube theta. This is nothing but H, this is nothing but K. Therefore, H power 2 by 3 plus K power 2 by 3 is equal to AB square. This is the same locus that we previously got. But in the previous question, we assumed the length of AB as 1. That is the only difference. This is the second approach. This is the physics approach. Now I want to discuss the highlight points in this particular question. IA over. This is the first highlight point. In this particular process, the importance goes to IA over and this point P. The point P which the velocity is parallel to the ladder. That is our point of concern in this particular question. One more time I am repeating why we are selecting only this point P. Because if we want to find the envelope, that is nothing but the outline of all the points which the ladder is enclosing with the x and y axis. In order to find the outline, we should need only the outer points. If it is having a component of velocity perpendicular to the ladder, that point might move somewhat into the curve. Therefore, we need not get the outline. Therefore, in order to get the outline, we need to select only those points which are having their velocities parallel to the length of the ladder. Therefore, I selected this point. This is the highlight point 1. And as previously discussed, the second highlight point goes to this OA. In order to find OA, we need to write this OA as AB cos theta. Because in H and K, we should get the same term here. Here if it is OA, here we are getting OB. Therefore, in order to convert into the same terms, we are considering OA as AB and OB as also we are writing AB sin theta. This is the second highlight point.
This is the question for the next week. Those who solve the question can mention the answer in the comment section below or email to us. Those who solve the question in the easiest way, their name and their photograph will be displayed in the next video. That is the solution for this question. Stay tuned.
Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please click the like button. If you have any doubts, you can mention them in the comment section below or email to us. One more thing I want to mention here. That is, we are going to release a new video which is very important to all those who are aspiring to crack any competitive examination, whether it might be JEE or NEET or KVPY or NTSC, all kinds of examinations. In this video, I am particularly dealing with how to concentrate in your classes, how to write your notes, how to write the short notes, how to read a particular book, how to minimize the time in your revision schedule. Therefore, you can go through the gunshot points and you can save the time. And I want to mention how to write the examination and the examination strategies and what are the things you need to take care before starting an examination or before the day of examination, all such kind of things. Please subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this and click the bell icon to get notification whenever we keep a new video. You will get a push notification on your mobile phone. Therefore, you will come to know that we have kept a new video. In order to get so, you need to subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon. If you have any doubts, please mention in the comment section below. Feel free and you can email to us so that we can clarify your doubts as early as possible.